95.1 FM, 790 AM. This is KFYO Mornings with Dave King and Matt Morning. Or Matt Martin. He goes by either way. He'll answer to either.
Hey,
and
that
of course,
guy over there.
Now you see, he's got me all off track here.
Well, let's get Jerry Reynolds on then.
Yeah, let's just get Jerry on the phone and let him take over because I'm making such a mess of it. It is Thursday and it's 7:36 a.m. So Jerry's on line one. Good morning, Jerry.
Good morning, fellow South Lake Keller. I haven't found this morning.
Oh, we are, and it's all messed up, so take it away and try to salvage this segment for us.
I will say this. You sent us some pictures of what you're driving. It's absolutely beautiful.
It is a pretty SUV. We're talking about the 2019 Infiniti QX80. And I've been interested in trying to get my hands on this because over the past year, for the first time that I can remember, this vehicle has moved into the number one spot in the luxury full-sized SUV segment. So that means it's outselling Navigator and Escalade and Lexus LX. I mean, it's a big SUV. There's no question about it.
Well, who makes the Infiniti? Remind me.
It's Nissan. Nissan's luxury line. And this thing's been around for a good while. I mean, they did a little bit of a refresh a couple of years ago, but really since 2010, this thing hasn't changed a whole lot. Now, this is a new trim level. This is called the Limited, and it is the top of the line. It does have a beautiful interior. And you're right, Matt, this thing is just it's beautiful to look at. It's got big 22-inch wheels and a really pretty gray color with a black and white interior
V8
inside.
Engine.
I'm sorry?
V8 engine?
Yeah, big 5.6 liter V8, 400 horses, which, you know, when you have a 6,000-pound SUV,
ooh,
you're going to need every bit of that.
Well, now, is it in the same class as the Tahoe?
It's larger than the Tahoe.
Oh.
It really lines up more with Escalade and Navigator and the really large SUVs. It has third row seats, obviously, and it's got good room behind the third row seat, which you don't always find with these SUVs. Sometimes,
yeah, like the Tahoe does not.
No, it does not. You're absolutely correct. This one does, actually. The thing that I think that bothers me about this one is it's missing some of the things that you would expect in an SUV for this price. And things like Apple CarPlay and Android Auto and a Wi-Fi hotspot. And they haven't changed the electronics at all. It's got a great stereo, but it's kind of cumbersome to move around the infotainment screen, and it's slow to react. And it's been that way in this vehicle for years. And that's one thing that I would have expected them to upgrade. I mean, Apple CarPlay, if you get used to using it, you can't live without it. And it's a deal killer for some people. If a vehicle doesn't have Apple CarPlay to work with their smartphone, they don't want anything to do with it.
No,
this one is
I understand
popping
that.
Out. I'm sorry?
I completely understand that because I use the Sync and with my Ford, and man, without it, it's not fun.
No, it's absolutely not. This thing is topping out at almost $92,000. And, you know, for what you get, I mean, it's nice, but I would expect it to have a lot more of the newer electronics on it for that kind of money.
So,
it does drive good. It rides good. It's quiet inside. Performs well. Little tow, 8,500 pounds. There's a lot of pluses to it. But so, I just think once, you know, when you get into that $90,000 range, you really want these things to have everything in the world on them.
So I'm looking, and now that you mention it, I'm looking where the what you call the infotainment center usually would be, like on a Ford or something, and I don't see a screen there. Where's the screen on it?
It's small, and,
okay,
and that's another issue. People want larger screens these days. I mean, I'm seeing some screens that are, you know, 12 inches diagonal.
Big.
And this one is really small. Same thing they've been using since 2010. And that's fine if the price reflects that. But at $91,000, I want it to have everything, you know?
Yeah.
But yeah, that's just me.
I completely understand. I mean, like I said, the interior looks great, but you're right. I didn't see the screen in there. It's kind of interesting.
Well, Jerry, what's the latest in the automotive news? What's happening in the world of automobiles?
Well, you know, it's May, and it's one of the favorite months of the year for the auto industry. Things seem to have picked up in May so far, and dealers are heading into the Memorial weekend, which is always a big sale weekend. So, in honor of that, at carprousa.com under the news tab, I've got Memorial weekend holiday car shopping tips. Things to do, because things are a little different around the car dealership when you get one of these really busy holidays. And dealers cannot afford to stock up with people, you know, to be able to handle the crowd, so it takes a little bit more patience. But I will tell you, dealers think volume on Memorial weekend, and this is one of the biggest selling weekends of the year. So I've got that up there. And I want to call attention to an article, and I kind of wrapped it around the fact that all the police agencies across America are doing the click it or ticket campaign this weekend,
right? Mm-hmm.
For people to buckle up. And I did a story a year ago this weekend about a young lady in Houston named Kaylee Mills, 16-year-old gal, just a beautiful, vibrant young girl. And she was riding in the back seat of a car with five girls in the car, and they decided they'd take a selfie. She undid her seatbelt just long enough to do that selfie, and there was an accident, and she was ejected and killed. And the moral of the story is, don't take that seatbelt off for any reason when you're in the car.
Yeah, and stay off the cell phone. I think there's two lessons there.
You're absolutely right. I don't know why this story got to me so hard last year. And, you know, you guys may or may not know, I don't know, I've lost a child. And so when you see other parents go through what you've been through, and you see...
Geez.
This thing was so preventable.
I can't imagine.
Well, and Jerry, talking about that, we had I saw the first story, and we had someone commented on it on our text line, but I saw the first story about a child dying in a hot car as well. And
yep.
That's something very preventable that seems to happen every year.
Yeah, and Texas leads the way, unfortunately.
Yeah.
In that, and maybe part of it is our weather. I'm sure that has something to do with it, but... you know, you just got to be careful. 37.6 million people are going to hit the road this weekend. That's a lot of people,
yeah.
You know.
So Jerry, you keep up with this. If you're shopping for a vehicle on this Memorial Day weekend, who has the best incentives?
Well, I'll tell you right now, Ford has got some amazing incentives. And we saw upward movement this week from all the manufacturers. Toyota was raising their incentives. As recent as yesterday.
Which is impressive because they don't like incentives very much.
Not so much, no. They really don't. I tell you, what you'll find this weekend that you're probably not going to find afterwards is a lot of manufacturers offering 0%.
No, really?
That's drying up. That is slowly going away. And yet there's a lot of them. That's why I say Ford, because their F-150's got 0% for 72 months. Through the end of this month. So that's something to look out for. There's big rebates out there. Lease deals get better on holiday weekends, too, and particularly with the luxury cars. When you're talking Lexus and Mercedes and Audi and Acura, they enhance their lease incentives to make the payments lower. So if you're thinking about leasing, this is a good weekend to do that, too.
All right, Jerry, your website's carprousa.com. Everything we've talked about is on that website, as well as many, many other things. The car we talked about will be up on Monday, the Infiniti.
Yep.
And you're also on our station from 11 to 1 every Saturday. Are you going to be there Saturday?
We will be live this Saturday.
Wow, for Memorial
Weekend. Such a big
weekend.
Shopping weekend. We're working to try to help people if they want to get out there and get themselves a bargain.
All right. Well, thank you, Jerry, for coming on. We'll talk to you next Thursday.
Have a good weekend, guys.
You too.